Hello viewers, welcome to my channel, Human Diseases and Genes. In 1914, British ophthalmologist Charles Usher provided a detailed clinical description of a syndrome that combined both hearing loss and progressive vision loss. His work was instrumental in identifying the association between these symptoms, and the condition was subsequently named Usher syndrome in his honor. Usher syndrome is a genetic disorder characterized by a combination of hearing loss and vision impairment, and in some cases, balance problem. It is the most common condition that combines these two types of sensory deficits. Usher syndrome is classified into several types based on the severity and age of onset of symptoms. Usher syndrome is estimated to affect approximately 1 in 6,000 to 1 in 12,000 live births globally. The exact prevalence can differ based on specific population and region. Type 1 Usher syndrome is the most common form, accounting for about 50 to 60% of Usher syndrome cases. Type 2 Usher syndrome is the second most common, representing approximately 30 to 40% of Usher syndrome cases. Type 3 Usher syndrome is less common, accounting for approximately 5 to 10% of Usher syndrome cases. Syndrome, particularly type 2, has a high prevalence in Ashkenazi Jewish population. Career rates for Usher syndrome are higher in this group compared to the general population. There is a higher prevalence of Usher syndrome type 3 in Finland due to a founder effect. Advancements in genetic research and increased awareness have improved the ability to diagnose and understand Usher syndrome, which can lead to more accurate prevalence data over time. As I have told, the symptoms of Usher syndrome including hearing loss, maybe congenital or early-onset hearing loss, reduced ability to see in dim light or complete darkness, that is night blindness, tunnel vision and vision loss associated with retinitis pigmentosa and balance problems due to vestibular dysfunction, delayed speech and language development, etc. Different types of Usher syndrome are caused by mutation in different genes. Type 1 Usher syndrome is caused due to mutation in Myosin VIIA, Usher 2A, CDH23, and CDH15 mutation. Type 2 Usher syndrome is caused due to Usher 2A gene mutation, and type 3 Usher syndrome is caused due to mutation in CLRN1, HARS, and Usher 3A. Myosin 7A gene is located at the long arm of chromosome 11 at position Q13.4, consists of 49 exons. The size of myosin 7A gene is 58.9 kb, encodes proteins of 2215 amino acids. So this syndrome is inherited in an autosomal recessive manner. Diagnosis of Usher syndrome is based on a combination of clinical evaluations, family history, and genetic testing. Given the progressive nature of the condition, early diagnosis is important for managing the symptom and providing the necessary support. Doctor will ask about symptoms such as hearing loss, vision problem, and balance. Family history of hearing or vision problem may also be important. Clinician will check for hearing loss using hearing tests such as audiogram, which measures hearing sensitivity across different frequencies. The ophthalmologist may conduct tests to detect signs of retinitis pigmentosa, such as visual field testing to detect peripheral vision loss and electroretinopathy, which measures the electrical response of the retina to light stimuli. Genetic testing is the most definitive way to diagnose Usher syndrome since it is a genetic disorder. Genetic testing can identify mutations in the genes responsible for the condition. Commonly tested genes are Usher 2A, Usher CA, Myosin 7A, CDH23, etc. Currently, there is no cure for Usher syndrome as it is a genetic disorder, but there are various therapeutic approaches to help manage the symptoms and improve the quality of life for individuals affected by the condition. Treatment typically focused on addressing the hearing, vision, and balance issues associated with Usher syndrome. The therapy options vary depending on the type and severity of the condition, but common interventions include hearing loss management, vision loss management, and balance dysfunction management. Since hearing loss is a major symptom of Usher syndrome, there are several options for managing it, like hearing aids, cochlear implants, sign language, speech therapy, and assistive listening devices. Regular visits to specialists, including audiologists, ophthalmologists, and vestibular therapists, are essential for monitoring the progression of the disease and adjusting treatment as needed. Early intervention and continuous care can help manage symptoms and maintain quality of life for as long as possible. Psychological counseling or therapy can help individuals cope with the emotional aspects of the condition, such as depression or anxiety, which can result from the progressive loss of sensory abilities. Research is going on to find potential treatments for Usher syndrome. Some of the experimental therapies under investigation include gene therapy, pharmacological treatments, and stem cell therapy, etc. This is all about Usher syndrome. Thanks for watching. If you found this video helpful and learned something new, please like this video and don't forget to subscribe for more health insights. Share this video with friends or family to spread awareness. If you have any queries, drop comments in comment box. Don't miss my next video. Until then, stay informed and take care of your health. Thank you very much.